Good evening all, and welcome to the webinar, Signature, a Demo on New Capabilities. I'm Shruti, your host for today's webinar. I hope everybody is able to hear me and also able to see the screen. If not, please type it in the chat window so I'll come to know about it. We'll wait for 1 minute more so that we have everybody joined in. Then we can start. Okay, let's start with the webinar. In today's webinar, we'll cover four major features that are live on Signature in the latest release. We'll have a Q&A session after the webinar. Also, you can get in touch with me for any queries or any questions. We also have a poll which will be run during the webinar. So let's see who gets the right answer for this. Okay, so the first feature which we have released in Signature with this release is the template. So you have a template section here, My Templates. So you can create a template here. Template is a standardized document which you can send to multiple signers. So you can create a template from here, and the parameters of that, of the signing process, will be reset by the uploader. So let's say I'm giving the document a name. I'll upload the document here. I'll get a category for it, which is a NDA, or sample NDA for ABC. Now I'll set the number of signers, which is a standard, which I'll set for only once. Like, let's say I want two signers for this document every time I use it. So I'll select two signers, observers, if I want a single observer. I'll make it save and next. So I'll select the signature type here, e-signature, whichever signature you opt in or you want to have a standardized format, you can select. So currently I'll select e-signature, put save and next. Select, place the placeholders for this document. The signer one is going to sign here, and signer two is going to sign here. I'll do it, save and next. And now I can save this document as a template. So I've saved this document as a template now. Now when I go to My Templates, I can see the sample NDA Aadhaar. This is a template which I have created. So I can, anytime I want to send it to somebody, I can just use it, and this steps will be reduced. Like when we are sending a document for signing, we have multiple steps here. So in this type, you will be having only a couple of steps where you can just select the signer, because we have selected attributes to the template, which is going to be only two signers, one observer. So we will just have to set these things and send the document. So I can select a signer here. I'll select Deepika as signer here. I'll select signer two as Nilesh Modi here. I can also decide the order of signing. Now, because I had, during template creation, I had selected a attribute of having the template having one observer. So I'll have to map one observer here. Now I can just select due date and these things if necessary. This was the major feature which we had released in the last release. So we'll do this and we can just submit. So that's it. In just one step, I could just send the document, the same document to these signers. So every time I have to send a standard document to different signers, I can do that using by setting a template, a basic template, which will have these all attributes. Like for a template, I'll be having two signers compulsory, one observer compulsory, two placeholders compulsory. So once I set all these attributes to the template, I just need to select the signers and some few other options, and that's it. So I can send a document in just one step. So that is one major thing which we have done. Editing the document is not possible. We can just create the template and the same document can be sent to number of signers. The next feature which we have released is a delegation feature. So let's just see a use case of this. So Deepika has sent me a document which I have to sign. So which is an NDA, and it is uploaded by Deepika, is created on this date and etc. I have option to sign now, but what if I don't want to sign and I want one of my colleague to sign it, or somebody from my team has to sign it because I feel this document is not for me. Maybe somebody else can sign it. So I can just delegate this document to that person. So if I want Yogesh sir to, you know, sign this document and I don't feel that I should sign this document, so I can just select Yogesh sir here, his name, and I'll just put a reason. Please sign this document as I feel you might understand the clauses. So I can just provide a reason here. I can delegate this document. I can ask Yogesh sir that please sign this document. I'm not the right person to sign this document. So I can delegate this document to him. Once I confirm, the document is sent to him. Now I can't sign this document. I won't be able to sign. I cannot see the document here. So it is went to Yogesh sir now, and now only he can sign the document because I have delegated that document for him. So this is one of the major features which we have released. Third, very most interesting feature which we have released is a location feature. So I'll just go through a normal signing uploading process. I'll select the type sample NDA for demo. And let's say I'm selecting signer myself here because I'm giving a demo. So I'll select myself as a signer. I'll select Deepika as the observer. Do save and next. Okay. So previously when we used to, you know, enable the location, it used to give us just a enable location feature, which is a tick like this. But now we can decide the radius in which the signer has to sign the sign the document. So if I decide that this location he has to sign the document, and I can also decide the radius. So if the person or the signer is sitting here, probably somewhere, or here, so he won't be able to sign that document. He has to sign it in this territory itself, in this 1 kilometer radius itself. So let me show you two use cases for this. So one is I will keep the location. So this is my location, and I'm giving a 1 kilometer radius to the signer. From this location, he can sign any time standing here in the 1 kilometer radius. So I'll just save. I'll set a reminder and the advanced options. Fine. So I got a notification here to sign. So now when I sign this document, because I had selected this location, I will be able to sign the document. So I can sign the document easily. So that's it. Now, what if I'm trying to sign not in that location, not in the given location. We'll try a use case on that also. So I'll upload a document here. Select the category. I'll select myself as a signer. Select observer. Save and next. Okay, now, so I am selecting the location, which is somewhere here. So I want the signer to sit here, which is a passer sign, and here in 1 kilometer radius only he can sign the document. Otherwise, he should not sign the document. So that is how I have enabled the location for the signer. This is particularly in terms of this was particularly done for the banking and the insurance sector, where people need to sign documents at particular places, at their client's place or their client's office. So this was particularly done for that type of industries. Yeah, and also in terms of biometrics verification, we can use this. I'll just select here and set a placeholder here. I'll finish this. Now what happens when I try to sign the document sitting at Baner location, and when the uploader has selected a location at some different place? So we'll see that also. Okay. So I'll draw my sign here. Now, when I try to submit, this is how it shows to me that you have to sign the document in this location with this radius only. So you cannot sign the document. You cannot submit the document. You have to be at this location and only then you can sign the document. You need to sign within the specified signing location. So this was the location which we had selected, which the uploader has selected, and I am sitting somewhere close to here. So I can't sign the document. So what else we can do is delegate the document to somebody else who's sitting at that place and belongs to your organization. So this is very very interesting feature which we have brought into Signature. Probably can be used when in the banking sector, in the insurance sector, where we need to sign documents using biometrics with the fingerprint, with Aadhaar, etc. Also, when the sales team or any of the team wants to also verify the home address of the signer, can probably use this location feature. Also, another fourth feature which we have released major is the preferences. So, like this feature is when you want to access somebody else's document. So if I want to access Yogesh sir's document, I can request access to his document. So here I can request access to his document. So I have a dummy account with me. So I will just ask Mr. David Hay to give access to his accounts. So I can just put his mail ID. Okay, I already have this. Okay, so I'm asking Mr. David Hay to give access to his documents. So I'm just sending him a request that I need to access your documents. So I can send him a request from here. So this is the action. I have asked David Hay, whose email is this mobile number, and I've asked him to share his documents with me. So this is how the request is generated when you want to when you have requested, so like this. So David Hay gets a request here from Shruti Vishnupurikar to access his document. So if I accept, Shruti will be able to access all the documents of David Hay. Similarly, if David Hay sends a request to Shruti, even David can access all the documents of Shruti. So this is particularly applicable where higher management want to access some finance documents, some HR documents of particular HR person, or maybe some finance team like this. So if I accept, so I can see the documents here. Yeah, just a minute. Yeah, so once the request is sent, I will get access to David Hay's documents from here, because I had requested David Hay to give access to his documents. So Shruti Vishnupurikar can also see David Hay's documents here. So I can see my documents here, plus I can see David Hay's documents here. So particularly applicable in terms where management wants to see the documents of finance team, for HR teams, or anybody for that matter. So if you want access to your colleagues, you can use this feature. This also is possible in cases where you know, people leave the organization and you still want to access the documents for that person. So you can do that also in this case, in terms of handing over or just showing what all activities have happened over the documents. So these are the four major features we have released with this latest release. And I hope they are quite interesting. The location features is very interesting, I feel. We have a poll which needs to be run out. So let's see who answers the poll. The poll is open. You can please vote your answers. And for any questions, any queries over these features, over this release, please type it in the chat window. I am available for all the questions and queries. Okay, so we have a question. Can you please demo on how to do live signature? Sure, we can do a demo on how to use live signature maybe in the next call, because we have to set up a live signature session for that, and it takes around 5 to 10 minutes. So we will take another call for that. Yeah, we can also share a video meanwhile of how live signature is done. Please ask for questions. Okay, we. Okay, we have another question which says, who has. I am not able to see the question. Just a minute. Can we create an admin account? Yes, we can create an admin account, and we can give access-based roles and permissions to our colleagues, to our team. Who has the rights to view all? Who has the rights to view all the people of organization? Okay, so for that we have a super admin panel which in which we can create licenses for a particular company, and that person will be able to access everybody's documents, will be able to see all the dashboard for all people. So maybe technical team can help with that account much better. Can we have live signature with location preferences? No, currently we cannot have live signature with the location preferences. When we assign others to sign, what information can I get? Could you be a little clear? I am not able to get this question. When we assign others to sign, what information can I get? So probably you received the mails and everything with all the activities on the documents that he has opened it. Maybe he has signed it. He's cancelled. He's declined to sign, or if he has delegated somebody else to sign. Nee, but I still get a mail about it. About delegation, yes, you will get updated about delegation. Like if I am delegating the document to Yogesh sir, then even he is updated about it. And yes, I am also updated about it. I get an email notification that I have delegated this document. He gets a notification that he has asked to sign this document, and I have delegated him to sign this document. In case of delegation, if the person is not aware of signature portal, how easy would it be to locate file and start working? Yes, so you get an email link, and if you are a guest signer, you can sign in as a guest one time. If not, you can register on signature and you can sign the document. So yes, delegation feature works in that way also. Okay, so we have some feedbacks here, which we can discuss later on the signature type. Any more questions we have here? Any more questions? We're still waiting for the questions. Why geofencing, and which are the target audience? I'm not able to get this question in terms of. Okay, why geofencing? And yes, as I told you, insurance and banking, probably any person who wants to sign a particular document at a particular place. Let's say at the client's place, at the client's office. So this insurance people, sales have got, you know, to sign their documents with their client at their place itself. So in that case, or the banking people, you know, they go travel to the senior citizen's place. So in that use cases, it is easy. Okay, I have missed a question. I need to check which question I have missed. Can't I expand this? Can you please demo how to use Live Signature? Yes, we will do it. Can we create an admin account? Yes, that also we can do it. Who has the rights to view all the people of the organization? That is super admin can view it, and we can give you access to that also. Can we have live signature with location preferences? That is a no. When we assign others to sign, what information can I get? So I am probably not able to understand the question. When we assign others to sign, what information can we get? Delegate. Okay, so in terms of delegate, you'll get no information. You'll just get an email that you have delegated this document, and probably you won't be able to access that document once you delegate it. Then when we assign to others, what information? Also, once you have assigned the document, like if you have delegated the document to somebody else and they have signed it, you also get a notification about that. When the person who has delegated it. We have some feedback here on the signature type, which we will, yes, we will do that. Yes, payment gateway is integrated. One big thing which we have really done is payment gateway is integrated. You can upgrade to paid plans, which is a starter team. Professional plans. Also, you can purchase the type of signatures like certified sign, Aadhaar signs. So we have already integrated that. You can go for paid plans also. Can we sell this to Indian customer and request him to pay online? Yes, we can do that. We have INR pricing too. Any Paytm cashback available? No. As of now, we have only dollars, but yes, if there's an Indian customer, we can come up with an INR plan. I think that's all for the question. We have a major feedback from Nisarg sir. So yes, we will take that into consideration and we'll also arrange a live signature demo for you. I hope these are all the questions we have. And if any more queries out of this, please get in touch with me or Yogesh sir. We can get back to you with this. Okay, so we have got poll answers. We had four answers, which is 100 ml, 500 ml, 1 liter and 5 liter. The question was, do you know on average how much water it takes to produce a A4 size paper? So we have 56% of responses who voted for 1 liter. And the answer is 5 liters, which we have received responses for 22%. So that's it for the demo today and questions. If any questions, we're still there. I'm still there online. You can please ask. No, PayPal is not yet live. Can we request you to have demo for client? Yes, sir, sure. I'll be very happy to do that. Thank you so much, Nisarg sir. Yes, sure. We can connect me for the customer demo. And I'm already doing it for a couple of clients and also with our sales team. So yes, I'll be very happy to do that. Yes, thank you so much everybody for staying online with the webinar and coming back with the next release very soon with the new features. And I hope as we have integrated the payment gateway, we would be getting good numbers now. Thank you so much. Thank you everybody.